Hey guys! Welcome to a new Ninja Monkey tutorial. I am Ajnan.
And I am Yeknam. Today we want to talk about different standard data types in TwinCAT 3. In TwinCAT 3 you have to assign the data type of a variable every time you create a new variable, otherwise you will get error messages. Variables are used to store information that are used in a program. If we label this information via our variable name clearly, the information can be understood better. The variable can be used in the whole program, multiple times. The data type determines how much memory space is allocated and how these values are interpreted.
All variables are declared between var and endvar, the name, a colon, the data type. In TwinCAT 3, we can use standard data types, which are described in the IEC 611313. This data types we want to introduce to you. We will start with the Boolean data type. The bool uses 8 bits or 1 byte of memory. It only can be 0 or 1, true or false. If you don't assign a value to the bool, the assigned value is false.
Next, we have the integer data types. The first 4 data types are representing a bit string. The bool, which we mentioned before, is also one of them. A byte occupies 8 bit of memory space, word occupies 16 bit, d word occupies 32 bit and al word 64 bit. D word stand for double word and l word for long word. All of this bit string literals are per definition neither signed nor unsigned. But of course, you can set a value range for them. In our table you can see the lower and the upper bound of each value. A byte has a value range from 0 to 255. That's why it's typically used to store characters. Internally the character is stored as a number.
Because this bit string literals usually store bit strings, it makes sense to write the values for these data types binary coded or as a hexadecimal number. If you want to write a value like this, you have to use the base format. If you want to write a binary, octal, or hexadecimal number, its base must be written before the integer number, followed by a hashtag. For binary numbers, it is base 2, for octal, base 8, and for hexadecimal, base 16. If you don't declare the base, the value will be declared with base 10. You also can use underscores. This makes the value easier to read. If you use hexadecimal as usual, you use A to F for the numerical numbers 10 to 15.
Now we look at the other integers. We always have a signed and an unsigned version for each of these data types. We start with the short int. It needs 1 byte of memory space and represents positive and negative integers. USINT requires the same amount of memory as the SINT, but because it is unsigned you have the double amount of positive numbers. We also have int and unsigned int, double int and unsigned double int, and long int and unsigned long int.
Next, we have the floating point data types. These data types are used to represent floating point values, as you can guess from their designation. Here we have the real and the long real. The real needs 32 bit of memory and the long real 64 bit. If you are familiar with C++, the equal for this kind of data types are float and double in C++. Now I will explain to you, for what you usually use a string data type. With this data type, you can store textual data. A string occupies 80 bytes of data plus 1 additional byte. The memory space required for a string variable is always 1 byte per character plus 1. But you can declare the string as big as you want. The characters are encoded according to the Windows 1252 character set. That's why you can use every character out of the table. If a string constant contains a dollar sign, the following 2 characters are interpreted as hexadecimal code according to the Windows 1252 coding. The code also corresponds to the ASCII code. If you want to use a dollar sign in your string, you have to use $$.
At this point, we also want to mention useful escape sequences. dollar single quote or dollar double quotes for quotes. Dollar L for line feed. Dollar N for new line. Dollar P for form fee. Dollar R for carriage return. Dollar T for tab. And dollar, less than sign. Two or four hexadecimal digits, greater than sign, for character of given code.
The Y string is also a string data type. The W stands for words. This data type occupies 80 words, plus one per character. That's because it's interpreted in Unicode, not in ASCII code. For some characters, several words are required for encoding a character, so that the number of characters does not have to correspond to the length of the Y string. If you want to use the special characters, you also use the dollar sign and the code for the character out of the Unicode list. We also want to mention that you use different quotation marks to assign a value to string and Y string.
For string types, it's important that you know that you have to declare the string length. Implicitly, the length is 80 characters. If you assigned a string with the length of 90 to a string that has no declaration of its length, the following will happen. TwinCAT will truncate the string to the maximum defined length of the destination string. TwinCAT does this silently. It could happen that you don't notice what's happening. To avoid this, you can use a data type, which is used in the Beckhoff libraries. The specific type is called tmax string, which is an alias for string 255. The data type uses a global constant variable, which is called max string length. It's an udint with the declared value of 255. If you declare a variable with this data type, it is a PLC string with the maximum length 255. Longer strings are allowed, but the string functions are limited to 255 characters. Next, we are looking at the time data types. They are used to store the data of time, dates, or both. The time data type is the most used of these kind of data types. It occupies 4 bytes of memory. The lower limit of the time range is 0 milliseconds, the upper limit is nearly 50 days. For setting the time value, you write t hash. After the hash, you can use the following time units: days, hours, minutes, seconds. They need to be arranged in this order, but you don't have to use all of the units. An overflow in the highest unit is allowed. An overflow at a lower position not. If you don't specify the values, TwinCAT uses the lower limit of the value range by default. Time of day or short TOD has the same value range as the time data type. The difference between both types is that time is used to specify time periods and time of day is mostly used to specify a certain point in time. If you want to specify the value for TOD, you have to write TOD in a hash, then hours colon minutes colon seconds colon milliseconds. Unlike time, you don't have to write H, M, S, or MS behind the numbers. Date uses 4 bytes of memory. You can use the date constant to specify a date. You either type date followed by a hash or D plus hash. The value looks like this and must be in this order: year minus month minus day. The time is specified in seconds. Date and time representing date plus time. It uses 4 bytes with a resolution from 1 second. You can either write date underscore and underscore time, followed by a hash, or short DT followed by a hash if you want to assign a value to the variable. You have to use the following format: year minus month minus day minus hour colon minute colon second. The time is specified in seconds. Interesting to know, the lower bound of these data type is the beginning of the Unix epoch. The Unix time measures time and date by the number of seconds since 0 o'clock universal time coordinated on January 1, 1970. Unix time is widely used in computing. The upper bounds of the data types also refer to events in the Unix time. The upper bound of date and time, for example, is the date where Unix time will reach the hexadecimal number FFFFFFFF or 4,294,967,295 seconds, which, for systems that hold the time on 32-bit and signed integers, is the maximum attainable. On 64-bit platforms, all of these data types are available as longs. Long time, long TOD, long DT, and long date. They occupy 64 bits of memory. With these data types, you can specify longer time periods. For example, the value range for long time also displays nanoseconds. Note that for the long date data types, except for long time, TwinCAT version 3.1.4026.0 or higher is required. There are other data types, like array, reference, or pointer, which we will introduce to you in one of our next tutorials. Have a great day.
Yeah, have a nice time. We hope you liked our content. If you want to learn more about TwinCAT 3, watch our other tutorials and subscribe to our channel. If you don't want to miss new videos, hit the bell. In the description of this video, you will find the link to the ekvip website. If you are into automation, this could be interesting for you. So, that's it for today.
Bye.
Bye.